I tried to figure out what time it was in St. Louis, my hometown. This operation had all the earmarks of being a real fight. At a time like this, you felt all keyed up inside, the blood coursing through your veins so fast your fingertips tingled. You wanted to get ashore quick and start getting some of those guys who were firing at our ships and scoring a hit every now and then. It seemed like hours getting to the beach. It began to get rougher, but my outfit, the 1st Battalion, 28th Marine Regiment, made it okay. We landed on schedule. It seemed weird, knowing how many Japs there were, getting set to let you have it, but not being able to see a one of them. Pretty soon, you knew for sure they were there. On the beach, it got really rugged. I never expected it to be this rough. Some companies were cut down to half strength that first morning, half their men knocked out. More men were landed, including the rest of my regiment, the 28th Marines. We had to hang on to that beachhead, whatever happened. What made it even tougher was the slow going in that volcanic sand. It slowed us down, and it slowed the equipment down. The fight for the beachhead at Iwo was a real nightmare. I don't think any of us will ever forget it. That first morning, about a third of the men in our company got hit. But we kept on fighting for that toehold. Iwo didn't get any more comfortable at any time during those first few days. The corpsmen had their hands full. They were busier than any of us. A lot of our equipment got bogged down in the loose sand and was knocked out by the enemy. And an awful lot of Marines got it on the beach at Iwo.